When I was photographing the ice houses, it was part of the extension of the body of work American Cities. And the Walker Art Museum had offered me a residency. And if you go there in the winter and you drive around the lakes, I mean, all you see are these kind of wonderful little ice houses. And I wanted them to be about these temporary communities, that they begin to exist only within this 2.5 month period. And also, you know, we have no idea how much longer the ice is going to get that thick in Minnesota. So again, it plays with these histories that I'm always looking at and beginning to repeat and acknowledge. The surfers are also the idea of a temporary community. So in the same way that ice fishing houses structurally begin to exist on the frozen lakes, the surfers are a constant, you know, temporary community that exists on the coastline. And when I got to move back to Los Angeles, it seemed natural that I had just finished the ice houses, that then I conceived of doing the surfers to be that companion piece to the ice houses, that I felt like the conversation wasn't really quite complete. And again, really, it's about what isn't kind of the iconic way that we begin to disseminate images. You know, most people think that a surfer photograph is out of the surfer magazine of this guy riding this really, you know, or woman, riding this great wave, and instead I've flattened it out. I've never seen the work together before. So one of the most exciting things for me is for the first time to finally see a moment that as an artist that you hope that you'll get to actually come to fruition, to see both the surfers and the ice houses across from one another. They go from being a little bit clearer to, in the surfers, they go to fog. In the ice houses, they go to blizzard. And believe me, it was much easier to wait for the fog than it was to be out on the ice with the blizzard. And there's this interesting thing that happens about waiting. There's a nice moment of me being able to be out there for hours, literally just waiting for kind of all the elements to come together for me in making the images. I try to take things and create a very highly aestheticized visual relationship of the way that people can enter work differently. Hopefully, I think what will happen is people will end up having other conversations about what their own preconceived notions are in relationship to landscape, the communities they live in, the gay and lesbian and transsexual and bi community. I think there's these little moments that are recognizably human. And I'm a very kind of humanistic person. And so any expectation that I have that I would like people to walk away with is the fact that we are all together in this as a species, and that we have to recognize this, and that we have to hopefully become just more human.